You were part of the jury since the beginning of Astra Film Festival, since 1993. What is your opinion about the Romanian documentary industry?
My opinion about the Romanian documentary industry is that, I mean, there's a lot of good, talented young people working in this industry, which is, you know, a new industry, but they lack the support, the institutional support, which enables documentary to be made. So there isn't support from the televisions, there isn't support from the ministry, and it's very difficult in those situations to make documentary film. I mean, there are some well-known names who've managed to sell some films on the international market by making various compromises, obviously, with that market. But younger filmmakers, people like Anca Hirte or whatever, I mean, it's very, very difficult for them. Mostly they have to make the films out of their own budgets without support, and that makes life very, very hard.
Okay, you are judging this year the Eastern and Central European section and the student section. What do you think about the movies that were submitted in those sections?
This year we had a very strong selection, both of student films, but again the focus, I mean deliberately, the organisers of the festival try and find student films from countries which aren't normally represented in the big international festivals. So we had a very nice student film from Ukraine, for instance, which I'm sure would not get seen normally elsewhere, so that was very nice. And some of the student films, the quality was extremely high. I mean, they weren't real life student films. You'd say these were kind of clear films with a kind of authorial voice and a style distinctive to the filmmaker. And the Central and Eastern European films were all very good, actually. I mean, you know, individuals in the jury disagreed about which ones they liked or not. But there was a very, very strong selection, including, you know, films, for instance, one made by a Romanian lounge in Germany and so on. So yeah, there was a big range of styles, a big range of ways of making these films and of kind of attitudes expressed in the film, but very, very good films.
Tell me something about your personal projects. I know that you have a study about Romanian documentary.
I wrote a little study for a book that will be published in Romania, looking at different aspects of Romanian documentary and looking at the challenges, I mean, as I was saying earlier, the challenges people face because of the pressures of budgets and the lack of institutional support, which means that it's very hard for Romanian documentary makers to kind of get out and pitch and get support internationally. So I looked at, I mean, I looked at all the main documentary authors over the past 20 years. And in many, you know, I mean, overall, you could say that Romania's got a sort of, you know, a strong and developing documentary industry. But I also looked at films specifically about Roma for in a separate article, and particularly looked, I talked about the film made by the director of this festival, The Curse of the Hedgehog, which is, I think lots of people agree, is the one of the best, if not the best, film made about Roma in Europe. So that's a nice achievement for Romanian documentary film.
Yes, indeed. How the Astra Film Festival is seen outside the borders?
So the festival is very, very global. I mean, that's quite distinctive in festivals in former Central and Eastern Europe. So this year, you know, one of the director of the Johannesburg South African Documentary Film Festival is here on the jury with me. In previous years, there have been filmmakers from Indonesia, Australia, America, South America, different parts of the world. So that's a very sort of marked characteristic of the festival, and I think it's a very popular festival. People come from all over Europe now to this festival, so that's a great achievement of Mr. Budrana.
How do you see the Astra Film Festival about, no, I don't know, the next 20 years?
It's a very hard question to say, but I mean, you know, people, festivals in a way have more and more of an importance because of the internet. I mean, there's so much of viewing is now done privately, or kind of, you know, on the computer, that the idea of having a place where you can meet people and talk about films becomes even more important. So I'm sure it will grow, and I hope it will become more stable financially with better central support from the government.
Thank you very much for this interview.